Feet hip width apart. Knees are soft. Tummy is pulled in. Shoulders are rolled up, back, and down. Let's wake up this body a little bit, eh? Extra towels out here.
One extra towel.
Just part of the back. Start off with a nice slow bow. Down to the knees, and then right up the thighs. Inhale. Down to the knees, and then right up the thighs. This is called a deadlift. Kind of wakes up the whole back side of the body. One more slow one, and then we're going to go to the beat of the music. Here we go. Bow, stand. Bow, stand. Dumbbells super close to your thighs. One more. Switch it up. Shake the butt of your shirt. This is called an upright row. Now notice how close it is to your body. Because we're about to add on to this. Clean and press starts with an upright row. Watch it first. If you need to clean, press, catch. Straighten up your shirt. Flip those dumbbells. Get underneath them.
Like having the weights here better than on your shoulders.
Big muscles, big weights. If it makes sense. However, if you know you've got any knee injury, hip, whatevs, you know, be smart about it. Weights are going to go up here, and we're going to be about hip width apart, maybe even wider, maybe a little wider, with the knees and toes slightly turned out. Here we go. Hike them up to your shoulders. Let's get ready to bust. Slow squat, really slow. 4, 3, 2, 1. Yeah, that's how low we can go. A smidge faster. Here we go. 4, 3, 2, 1. Up.
Move your body, okay?
So far in the medium range, okay? So not as heavy as your legs. Go a little lighter if you're brand new. Maybe your eights. Your eights are fine. If you've been doing this for a while with me, 10s, 12s, 15s, you got it. We've got flies that are open and closed. We have a press that's down and up. And then we have pullovers that go up over our head. Now, I know that's new for a lot of us. So if you want to just use one weight for that pullover, awesome, I love it. You're going to grab it by the bone ends, okay? Here we go. So lay down, angle your body, so it's easy to see. What did I have, 15, okay. All right, we're going with it. Starting the up position with your wrists facing in. A fly is open and closed. Inhale to open, exhale to close. Open, 2, 3, 4.
So
bar, and the bar is about yay big, okay? And these weights, they're much bigger. So if you're like, why am I feeling at the top of my hand? It's because it's a different grip. It's something that we're not used to, okay? All right, my friends, we're taking it to arms. Arms. Does she need some? Oh, she got me. So biceps, triceps combined. Biceps, triceps combined, okay? If you've been doing this for a while, go ahead. Go ahead. Start with the eights. Start with the tens. You can always drop down later. You can always drop down later, okay? Biceps curls, kickbacks. Here we go.
Slow.
side, having up on your shoulders, we're gonna do a step up. And what can't be done, even though we physically don't have a step, do a step up too. We just gotta change the mechanics a little bit. So here's our lunge stance. Right now, my body's pretty upright, but if I lean forward a little bit, this leg, that's gonna be our step up leg. So there'll be a distinct, hey, I'm short, hey, I'm tall. Kind of feels like you're taking off, up and away. Weights, you decide. I'm not even gonna use weights, because I feel it, okay? I might use a weight. I might. Yeah, it's gonna go back down to the floor, you bet. All right, so remember that four-part lunge? Now lean behind you, quick check. Is that my phone going off? Oh.
Step your foot out.
especially if you have any kind of injury, go like. Feet hip width apart. You can also get away with standard stance. Roll those shoulders up, back, and down. And just think, shoulder level. We don't need to go any higher than shoulder level in the beginning. Anything extra is extra. Reset those shoulders. Up, back, and down. Lift up that heart. Right arm to the front of the room. Even the chin. 2, 3, 4. Yes, warrior. Half front. Extend your legs out long. Reach your arms up overhead on the floor. Woo. Take a deep breath here, and whether you want to flip your whole body around or just roll over, take it to a cobra or a love dog if you're used to that. Basically, we just want to stretch out the front of our body. One more inhale here. As we exhale, pull those hands underneath your shoulders and then take it all the way back into a child's pose stretch. What I suggest is taking a towel, and if you put it down like this, then you can kind of melt yourself all the way down in between your thighs. Extend those arms out away from your body. Now keeping your head and your heart down low, take both of those hands, start squeezing them to the right. Feel that stretch going down the left side of your body. One more inhale, keeping your head and your heart down. Scoot it over to the other side. Let it creep down the right side of the body. And then back to the center. Think scared cat. Scared cat. As we inhale, drop the belly down. Eyes look up at the ceiling, curl the toes under. Now we're going to lift up into a downward facing dog. Now all that is kind of upside down C. Spread your fingers out, you won't slip. Inhale, now right leg up. Step it in between the hands. From a runner's lunge, carefully drop that back knee, release the toes. Inhale, hips are going forward, body's going up. Right hand, give yourself a pass back. Take that same padding arm. Bring it across your leg. Shoulder stretch. So left hand is free. Left hand is going to go down on the floor next to your right foot, and then we're going to twist. Give towards that leg. Some of us might want to pop that back leg up. Others, you might want to throw in a quad stretch. You decide. Let's meet back in downward facing dog. Inhale that left leg up. Step it in between your hands. From a runner's lunge, carefully drop that knee. Hips are going forward. Body's going up. Left hand.
If you get time to put your weights back on top of your mat, that would help me out. We don't even have to